Welcome in, everyone. I'm Slay, and today we're going to discuss a pretty easy way for you to add sunken roads and railways into your city. I'm going to try to keep this pretty limited on mods and assets so that this is more accessible for everyone. There's obviously other ways to do this. You can check out my retaining wall video for a kind of an indication of a different direction you can go in, but this is a pretty simple thing that I've been doing lately in some of my cities that's relatively efficient and gets you a pretty good look. So be sure to check the description for details on certain assets and mods that you will need to do this. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button if you enjoy the video, and be sure to leave a comment on what you think our next tutorial should be. And don't forget, we do a lot of these builds live at twitch.tv/slay3k. So come check us out sometime. So let's first discuss what you're going to need to be able to do this. You're definitely going to need Moveit, and you will need Key Anarchy. Along with that, Fine Road Tools and Road Anarchy are going to be critical. You can be a little bit flexible with what key you're going to use. I'm going to use the one from the Content Creator Pack for Bridges and Piers that came out in 2021. Now, I'm going to be using a railway for this first example. Keep in mind that roads work the exact same way. They are both similar networks. So if you'd rather use a road to be sunken down into the trench, go for it. The process is the same. Now, this is a relatively simple way to go about this. We're going to use keys to help with the terraforming aspect of it. So you can see I've already laid out a railway next to a road. I want to encompass the space between there to house the key. Now, you could have the key actually overlap a little bit of the sidewalk. I'm going to do that to some degree, but I'm really going to kind of make an extension of the sidewalk. So since I already have a pretty good idea of where I want my railway to go, I've laid it out instead of actually, you know, hitting page down as I'm laying it in place. I'm going to go ahead and sync it using Moveit. You can do this by selecting the nodes involved and hitting page down. Once it's in place, I'm going to go to the ends and I'm going to rework the slope to kind of make it smoother using Moveit, which you can do by highlighting the three nodes from end to the other end of the slope and then hitting slope objects. Now, if you are having any sort of collision issue when you're trying to place your first key, go into Road Anarchy and make sure that collision is turned off and that anarchy is turned on. So my first goal is to remove the cliff that is now present by the terrain change. Obviously, it's super drastic. The mountain cliff type texture doesn't look great here, especially in an urban area. Now, the important thing to realize is that I'm using the train track and the road to compress that space. That's why it looks so jagged and intense in terms of the cliff itself. But as of right now, there's nothing else that's controlling the terrain height. It's just the two networks. Now, I'm going to try to perfect how the key is going to be placed. This can get a little bit finicky, so be prepared to have some patience when you're trying to apply this. So for those of you that are not very familiar with Moveit, check out my Moveit tutorial. But for a quick recap on how to use Moveit in this situation, basically I'm selecting the nodes at either end or in the middle of the key, and then I'm using page up and page down to actually change the height of the key next to the road. So for my railways, I'm using the North American Rail assets from the workshop. To blend this in better with the key, I've used Theme Mixer in order to select a specific texture that I can use in Surface Painter to fill in the space between the railroad itself and the key. This is totally up to you if you want to fill in this space, obviously, but I think it looks much cleaner when it's filled in with either a gravel or a pavement texture or something like that. I also want to add in some overpasses over the train line that can cross to the other side of town. So I'm going to pick the road I want to use, and then I'm going to select elevated in the Fine Road Tools option so that the road is forced to be something like a bridge. It's going to be forced to go above the terrain and not be conforming with the ground. So obviously your distance between roads and over the railway can vary depending on what you're trying to do. I'm going to add a little bit more space because I want to show just a couple of complicated things you might be dealing with on the other side. I'm going to go ahead and update this road to transition back to a road that conforms with the ground. This is important. It's going to then compress the space a little bit and give us our cliff texture on this side. The space inside of your trench is totally up to you. I try to make it look as realistic as possible and give enough space for however many railways or roads I decide to put within the trench. But again, totally up to you and how you want to set it up. All right, so let's try to clean up underneath the overpasses. Obviously, there's a big gap here. So let me show you some issues you might run into. I'm going to switch to a type of key that doesn't have the railing. This might be important for you if you're going to use a different type of keys to make sure you have an asset prepared to go underneath something like an overpass. This could be a wall or something that you place more manually. I'm going to use a different version of the same key. So you can see when I begin to add to this key, it's going to mess up my fencing. It may even stretch your keys depending on which one you use. It doesn't look ideal. So I'm going to do this a little bit differently, and what I'm going to try to do is just make little areas that are going to fit, and like a small network piece that can fit underneath the overpass that I then don't actually connect to the rest of the key. They're just gonna be little inserts. So you'll see here is that I'm actually gonna leave it short of connecting, and then I'm gonna select the end of the key that I need to then extend and extend it over to the small insert I've created. And you can do this pretty easily as well using move it. I select the end node, I hold alt, and then I pull to keep a straight line. Now, sometimes you're gonna have little funky issues with keys. Sometimes they'll be flipped. This can be a common problem when I'm placing down keys, depending on terrain, height, and just what's going on. It may just take some, you know, playing with until you get it to work appropriately. You can try changing different heights and tweaking things. Sometimes you have to place things and move them back into the spot a couple of times before it works the way you want. I haven't found the one size fits all fix to keys when they flip the incorrect way. That meaning that the railing would be facing the road instead of the drop off. I tend to think that it has to do with something interfering with how the key is interpreting the height change. So you may then have to use assets that control terrain conforming or something like that. So if you're using the road, you may have to move a road node out of the way for a minute, put the key in, and then replace the road node into the spot it was. So now that I've added another overpass and I've gotten our key into the majority of the side that we're trying to cover up, I just want to demonstrate one more time how this little insert piece works. It's pretty straightforward, but just in case it's confusing. You can also see that it's lining incorrectly. It's flipping the wrong way. And even though I'm flipping it, it's still going back to the pre-assigned way that it thinks it needs to be. However, by the time I place it, the terrain has changed enough that it's actually going the correct way. I'm going to sink this down in the ground using page down with move it, and we have it in place. Now holding alt, I can then extend the node of the other key to line up closer to the insert underneath the overpass. Now you may be able to use something like a retaining wall or a prop wall here. Again, entirely up to you and how you want to fill that space underneath. This to me tends to leave a pretty smooth finish, especially when you spend a little time and you tweak it into the position you need it. I try to make sure the railing on the key matches up with the railing that is on the bridge, so it doesn't look like people could just fall off into the trench. Now, as you can see, you get a pretty good effect from this. It looks smooth, like it was designed this way, and that's the key for me. Pun slightly intended. Now, as we progress to the other side, I've left a little bit more space here, and this is going to come with a complication or two. We're going to have more space to fill between the road and the key itself. And we're also going to have like a small divot where the bridge connects to the road that's conformed to the ground. So your first idea might be go to Surface Painter to fill in that space between a key and a sidewalk. However, Surface Painter tends to leave some lines in it that drive me crazy. So I'm going to show you an asset that I've used a bunch and talked about a bunch to fill in the space. And it's a brush asset. This basically paints the same sort of textures you have in Surface Painter over an area without interfering with what's already there. It's fantastic for filling in spaces like this where you wouldn't really notice anything as long as that gap doesn't exist. The only problem is it's not going to cover up a ditch or some sort of hole in the ground. And I'm going to have to show you a different asset in case you have this issue arise. So right now I'm pushing the key away from the road, which is going to give us a little bit of a gap. So I want to fill that up and I want to give you guys an idea as to what you could use to spice this up a little bit, make it look a little bit neat. And that's really actually pretty simple, because if you look here, there's a lot of gray, right? It's very bland. There's not much color. Adding something like a planter box with flowers or trees or something like that, anything with like green or color is going to look really, really good here. And it's going to stand out because of all the gray around it. So let's skip forward a little bit and let's talk about an issue that I ran into when I started to separate the road away from the railway. I have this little ditch that's actually showing up next to the node where the bridge connects to the terraformed road. This is a common problem when you're usually mixing in like elevated roads and roads that are terraformed. It happens. You could put plants in here, bushes, whatever. I'm going to show you another example of how to fix it just in case this question comes up. So I talked about this asset in my detailing tips and mods video. This is ploppable pavement. It's going to act as a flat prop, basically, that can cover up stuff and cover up the ditch itself. Now, much like brushes, this doesn't act or do anything like pathing. This is simply a cover-up method for fixing something that we have that might be conceived as a mistake or some sort of issue there where these networks are tying together. I'm going to use move it along with page up and page down to get the height of the ploppable pavement correct, along with the node there at the end of the key. This is a little bit of tweaking just to make it look as clean as possible, but you can see it does a pretty good job of covering up any issues here. I'm trying to make a good point of this because I know that sometimes you'll be doing something that looks like, you know, it should work a specific way in the tutorial, And then if you start to bend it beyond what the tutorial shows, you guys will run into like an issue or something that you're not sure how to cover up. So poppable assets like poppable pavement and the brushes I used earlier are a couple of the mainstays in my asset list to cover up mistakes or things that the game tries to do that can be easily looked at and say, that looks awkward or weird. I can use these assets to fix those things. Now, sometimes what you're gonna run into is an issue where the height of the key may be slightly different from the road and it may make a like lip between where you have the sidewalk and the key itself. This is a little bit more difficult to cover up. You could try to use poppable pieces. You can try to alter the height of your key. Sometimes it gets really, really intense with how many nodes you're gonna need to exactly match, especially if you're not using very even terrain. Typically in these situations, that's where I start to look at adding green space or planters just to cover up that lip. It also forces me to add some variety in here and get away from concrete everywhere. Something else I'd consider doing is adding paths. Paths that connect your key, especially if there's a walkable path for Sims, to your sidewalks. This may promote Sims to actually walk along the keys. This is really nice, and with some green space or some planters, it starts to look like a really nice environment. Use props, trees, bushes, whatever you can to start to cover up little areas that maybe don't look as good as you'd like them to. And remember, brushes and ploppable assets can really help cover up those little spots where cities just doesn't seem to work with you. So like I mentioned before, your railway and roads are gonna work the same when you want to insert them into a trench or create a trench around them. What I would definitely recommend is taking the time to plan what you're gonna have in the trench beforehand, because you can't just update rails to be roads. You're gonna have to actually switch the physical items. So just take a minute and make sure that whatever you're gonna insert in the trench is kind of what you intend to be there. Moving it and shifting it around a lot using Move It can sometimes get a little finicky as well. It's pretty easy to add another network to the trench once you have one laid down. Typically, I'll plan out how many train lines or how many roads I intend to place into this space beforehand. So if it's only one, then I'll lay the one down. If I wanna add another one, I try to get one pretty much positioned the way I want, because I'm going to utilize the one that's set and I'm going to try to match it, especially on the slopes and things, so that the ground and everything looks like it should. My recommendation is just to try to align the networks as best as possible utilizing the nodes. And that means running the road parallel with your existing network and then also just matching where the beginning and end is. Typically, that's going to make the segments between nodes about the same length, and then you can just match the heights along the way. Now, that's not a perfect system, but it'll kind of get you laid out the way you need to. You can see that sometimes networks won't just know what you're thinking, so you may have to realign some nodes again to the appropriate height. You may have an extra node here and there that you'll need to align. Those things happen. You can always adjust manually if you need to. I just think it's important to try to match the slopes, or you'll have those gaps between the two networks. And remember, just add some details and you can make this look pretty good. Consider adding network fences to divide certain things, maybe different concrete barriers if you have multiple roads. Things like that will add a lot of depth and some interesting little tidbits that might really enhance your city. Now, with this tutorial, I'm obviously relying very heavily on the keys and the networks to handle terraforming. If you do have issues and you need a simple tool to help you fix some of these terraforming issues, I do have a solution for that. This is a pack of assets called Terraforming Network Extended. Now, they do act as networks similar to roads or railways, but the idea is that they're invisible and all they do is really help you modify the terraforming or terrain itself. You can create slopes, hills, or trenches utilizing Move It, page up, page down, just like you would a normal network. I hope this tutorial has been helpful for you. This is something maybe a little bit more on the medium complexity area. It doesn't require a lot of things to be able to do it, but I wanted to make something that was rather approachable for everybody. You could go to a much further extent if you start using prop walls instead of network walls. If you want to do your own terraforming and not rely on the keys, there's a lot of different routes you could take. If there's something you'd like to see in a future video, be sure to leave a comment below. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this and subscribe. Here are a couple other videos you can check out on the channel, and I'll catch you next time.